Hey guys, welcome to Smallmouth Crush. My name is Travis, and I'm all about fashion, keeping it real, keeping it styling, profiling, and doing a little bass fishing. So today, I'm gonna go through what I wear in some extreme weather conditions coming up. Okay, so this time of year, it's hard to determine what's gonna make you feel comfortable out on the water. So I generally will have a lighter weighted type of rain gear, windbreaker style, and then I'll also take this bag with me here, and this bag stays in the boat late fall all the way into early spring when I know for sure I'm not going to need this piece of equipment. But this is my real cold weather gear, and I'm going to go through that with you of what I carry with me when I'm facing those extreme climate changes during a typical day on the water. All right, listen, so I am a fanatic when it comes to staying comfortable while I'm fishing. And so let's talk about what I wear during the warmer months. Say it's out in the summer and you get the occasional thunderstorm that rolls through, or even a downpour or something that lasts all day long, I needed something that I wasn't gonna overheat in. So if I'm flipping or pitching or working a bait fast and really getting into it, and it's just like, it's the last thing on my mind, I mean, a lot of times I'll just get rained on before I put that heavy rain jacket on because I just dreaded the fact that, and the fact I was just so consumed in the fishing that, I mean, it takes a lot for me to go pull this thing out. But when I do, I'm glad I have it. This is actually a jacket made by Stormr, and it's, I believe it's a Nano jacket. It's a real lightweight jacket. So I can wear shorts and a t-shirt underneath this, and you know, when the need arises that I do have to wear a jacket like this, I can pull this out. It's very lightweight. It has the pants. It has the jacket. Even in the cooler mornings, it's great to run, you know, run down the lake to your first spot before the sun gets up and gets too hot. It zips up great. Plenty of protection. I got the hoodie back here. I'm running down the lake in a thunderstorm. I'm good to go. It also allows me to tighten up the sleeve so I don't get any water running down my wrist and my hands, and it's really an all-around go-to jacket. I'm glad I found it. This is definitely something I would suggest purchasing. I've tried a lot of them out there. This is just so lightweight, and you don't feel confined to the jacket, and it's really going to allow you to you know, take advantage of those hot days and still stay dry and comfortable. Okay, so when it gets extremely cold, I have to pull out the Stormr Strykr suit. And these are actually the bibs that come with it, and then the jacket I'll show you as well. But the bibs are awesome because you can adjust it back here. There's great padding that allows you to still move around. And this is all neoprene. This is extremely warm. It's got some great pockets right up front. It also has zipper pockets as well. And then there's also pockets on the legs here with Velcro. You can stick stuff in there. All that stays dry. And I mean, it looks bulky and big, but it really does its job. It keeps you warm. It has, I mean, they put a lot into this suit itself, just as far as the quality goes. I've had this now for 2 years, and it still looks great. I've done a lot of fishing in it, and it's definitely my go-to outfit, especially in late fall. Okay, here's the jacket itself. Again, it's made to match the bibs. Everything flows perfectly. It's got a lot of pockets, a lot of storage on the chest as well as down here for hand warmers. And it's just an all around great jacket. It's got a great hood. And you can really just tuck in and get away from the elements if you have to. And again, this, I'm talking 40 degrees or, you know, 45 or lower temps. If you wear this, and I have, in, you know, when it's 50, 55, and 60, you're really going to overheat in it. I mean, it's that warm. It's really designed for winter fishing. Extreme temperatures, when there's ice on your boat, when there's snow on the boat, and the big fish are chomping, this is my go-to as far as trying to stay warm and comfortable all day. So I'm not big into gloves and mittens when I'm fishing. In fact, they always seem to get in the way, and it's just such a hassle. But when I am running down the lake, driving the boat, or whatnot, mittens, I guess these are mittens, right? The mittens are the go-to. And you can find a good pair pretty much anywhere. You know, I would definitely invest in a good pair of mittens just to keep your fingers from freezing while you're running. They're useless for fishing in. And really, even gloves are pretty much useless for me. I love to be able to feel and work the reel. And it just seems constricted with gloves like this. But I do have these pair. These are from Sims. I've had these for years. They work great. They got some sticky gel stuff on the fingers to give you a better grip. I do have some gloves that have the fingers cut out of them. But, I mean, I normally don't wear them while I'm actually fishing. I just, you know, wait 10 minutes until your fingers go numb and you can't feel anything anyways. So the gloves, you know, it's essential to have a good pair for running and whatnot, but when it comes to fishing, you're kind of on your own there. I prefer not to wear them at all. All right, so I'm all about the flip-flop, right? The flip-flop lifestyle, the tan lines, everything that goes into flip-flops, the time of the year, I'm all about it. I've been known to wear flip-flops in March. However, a lot of times when you're out there and it's snowing and blowing and cold, and I got that Strykr suit on, I'm also gonna have a good pair of boots. These boots are made by Merrell. They make a lot of great shoes and boots and whatnot. I found that that brand is a pretty solid brand. I've had these boots for quite a few years. I really only wear them when I'm out in the boat, so they don't get a lot of, they don't get worn down or they're not all beat up. But they're waterproof. They keep my feet nice and dry, and they pair up great in cold weather conditions. So I'll wear some wool socks with these, and I'm normally good to go there. All right, and a lot of times I might be wearing a ridiculous hat like this, but I love these things. I got like five or six of them in different colors. And this is my style, you know what I mean? It's nice and warm, it's fashionable, looks great. I love it. What do you guys think? So hey, in the comments below, let me know what you guys wear during some crazy weather conditions. What's your favorite gear to wear during the summer? I'd love to hear about it. Please subscribe to my channel, give me a like, and we'll see you guys on the water. Hopefully when it's warm.